Oh, Cheltenham, I'm a bit anxious because I'm going to be under the spotlight in a very major scientific scandal. Or maybe a Nobel Prize, so I don't know yet. And this is up to you. So that's a bit of an odd situation, let me explain. So I'm a guy, I like cleaning, and cleaning is a very general habit. All animals clean themselves. For example, the cats lick themselves, the turtles, and even the worms, they clean themselves. So because if we don't clean ourselves, we live shorter because of bacterial infections. But my problem is, I can't stop cleaning. I love cleaning. And it's not only me. There are also some mice, for example, that are cleaning themselves so much that their skins are wounded. And the pups of these mice are also obsessive. So this means that actually this behavior must be genetic, and there must be something wrong with their brain. And when you look at the DNA of these obsessive mice, actually, one of the genes is missing. And this gene is unbelievably not in the neurons of the brain, but actually in the white blood cells in the brain. So this is weird, because we always thought that the behaviors are controlled by our neurons, billions of neurons. But it looks like a white blood cell can control our cleaning behavior. Is that even possible? And when you transfer the blood from a healthy mouse to an obsessive one, actually you can cure the behavior. And this is big. It is very hard to change the behaviors. Albert Einstein said, it is harder to crack a prejudice than an atom, like with the German accent. So probably, so that's why this is a really big thing. That it's so easy to change a behavior to cure a psychiatric problem with just transferring blood. Cheltenham, today what I want to tell you is that the underlying reason of my cleaning habit actually can be used for, in democratic societies, to create a healthier, psychologically healthier population. But in an authoritarian society, then it can cause, for example, mind-controlled masses. So that's why it is up to you, basically, to decide what should be done with this information. That's why I think science communication is very important for you to get prepared for future challenges. And that's why I'm here, beyond any competition, to tell you that you should get prepared for the future challenges. And that's why I'm telling you the scientific reason behind, or the mechanisms behind, so you can decide for your future with your own free will while you still have one. Thank you.